what you feel on you. Like what?
Like clothing fire.
They need it. Glory. And when I do it, something will be released on you. And the Lord is telling me to do this, so I have to. Keep playing it. While I've been ministering, the anointing has been pouring into my jacket. Are you ready? I'm going to just wave my jacket that way, and that way. And when I do, that anointing is going to hit. You ready? Father, do it. In the name of Jesus. Lift your hands and worship Him, my name. Adore Him now. Alleluia. Miracles began happening while I was preaching tonight. Alleluia. 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 Thank you. singing.
Hallelujah.
No one using a microphone singing now, please. Just the people. Lift your hands to heaven. Receive your miracle. I rebuke that sickness. I step into my office and I rebuke every disease in the name of Jesus. Alleluia. I command cancer to go in the name of Jesus. I command blindness to go in the name of Jesus. I command every demon of disease and infirmity to go in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, be made whole from the top of your head to the soles of your feet. I command every demon spirit that has afflicted your body in the name of Jesus, go! Now lift your hands, all of you, begin to pray out loud in the Holy Ghost as God heals His people. There's miracles happening all over this building. Many of you feel tremendous fire on your body. Many of you feel heat all over your body. Some of you feel like electricity rushing through you. Some feel like a vibration in your body. That's the power of God healing you. Check that disease, it's gone. Cancer has just been healed. I command it to go. Tumors are leaving. Go. Crippled legs are being healed in Jesus' name. Be gone. Blindness be gone. Deafness be gone. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, be gone. Skin cancer be gone in Jesus' name. Glaucoma be gone in Jesus' name. Many of you feel, keep praying. Many of you, dear people, feel tremendous power on your body. Check that sickness out, it's gone. And once you know that sickness is gone, get out of your seat and come line up to the left over here quickly. If you know the Lord is healing you, or the Lord healed you while I was preaching, some of you are healed while I was preaching. Check that sickness out, it's gone. The pain is gone. You can breathe again. You can see again. You can hear again. You can walk again. Come out of that wheelchair in Jesus' name. Come out of that wheelchair in the name of Jesus. Come out of your disease in the name of Jesus. Come out of your sickness now. Keep praying. Those that are getting healed, quickly get over there to the left. Sinash, help me over there, my dear, like you did last night. the young man, help me go over there quickly. Lift your hands of prayer, everyone. Lift your hands of prayer. A tumor just left. A tumor just disappeared. Come and stand over here to the left. Every one of you that felt that heat, everyone that felt that vibration, that electricity go through your body, and you know, like that woman with the issue of blood, she knew and felt in her body she was healed. If you know God has healed you, don't wait for a second. Don't wait for me to call out your healing. There's no way I can call every healing out. Play it for me. Arise and be healed in the name of Jesus. That faith arise in your soul. Let faith arise in your soul. Rise and be healed in the name of Jesus. He will touch you and make you whole. Rise and be healed in the name of Jesus. Let faith arise in your soul. Rise and be healed in the mighty name of Jesus. He will touch you, make you whole. Keep praying, keep praying, keep praying. Lift your hands, keep praying. God is still healing his people here. Jesus, oh Jesus, Jesus, oh Jesus. Everyone pray right now. And the choir, sing it with me. Jesus, oh Jesus, your presence. Everyone just keep praying, keep praying. Choir, sing it. Jesus, oh Jesus, Jesus. There's a lot of healings happening, a lot of miracles happening, and those that are getting healed, you need to come and stand over here. What happened, my brother? What happened?
Master, this lady,
bring her up here.
She fell in her bathtub 3 years ago and fell on her ribs. She's been having pains on her ribs and has been on medication, has not been able to lift her right hand. The power of God came upon her there.
What was she wasn't able to do? What?
She wasn't able to lift her right hand.
Pick her up.
Because of the pain, severe pains on her ribs. She fell in a bathtub 3 years ago and has been on medication for those 3 years.
Pardon?
I cannot sleep by the side.
Not now, dear. Jesus. Lord, no more. Say hallelujah. Take your seats. Take your seats. Help her up. Many of you, she can go down now. Many of you were healed while I was speaking. There's a lot of people in the line I see. Just lift your hands for just 30 seconds and pray in the Holy Ghost. That's all. What happened to that?
She is 23 right now, but when she was 13, she noticed that her right leg was shorter than usual. But now, as you were praying, she feels that a leg has grown out and is growing out. She said as she's walking down, it keeps coming out, and she knows she has been healed. Praise the Lord!
He's here right now. Is your leg growing still? Huh?
Yes, sir.
Feel it growing. Every bit of it. Every bit of it. Every bit of it. every bit of it. In the name of Jesus. Ghost! Something is happening over there. I don't know what's going on, but something is happening over there.
Pastor,
bring her up. And I don't know what's going on, but somebody just got healed over there.
Pastor.
Oh my God. He could not walk. The man could not walk.
That's his wheelchair.
Bring him up here. Leave him alone. Leave him alone.
He could not do that.
Bring him here. Bring him here. Are you his mother? Lord, make him whole from the top of his head to the soles of his feet in the mighty name of Jesus. Your son could not do that? Pardon? Only on the wheelchair. For how many years? From birth? He's 20 years old. He has not been able to walk. The Lord has begun the healing. The Lord has begun the healing. Stretch your hands and say, in the name of Jesus. Pastor, come on with me. Lord, what you have begun, complete. Complete it in the mighty name of the Lord. That's just the beginning, my dear. That's just the beginning. Keep him walking and you'll see the change come. Come on, brother. He doesn't need your help.
Somebody shout hallelujah.
Help him down. Help him down.
Pastor,
what happened? Yeah.
She had brain tumor for 3 years. She couldn't stand by herself for 5 minutes. But the power of God came upon her. She'd be standing there all the while. She couldn't stand for 5 minutes.
Bring her here. You had a brain tumor? My dear, I'm talking to you. Hello?
I have a brain tumor and I went to the hospital in Abuja. They said that they're going to operate me. And when I came to this place, before now, I can't stand for 5 minutes. Everybody that knows me, I usually stand, I usually sit down whenever we're doing anything. But here, immediately I came in, I sat there yesterday, and I cannot withstand any noise. But that yesterday, when I was there, the Spirit of God came, and I had a touch, and I fell at my back. I couldn't hold it. When I was there too, the ocean of the Holy Ghost was so much on me that I cannot keep it myself. Honestly, I don't know. I cannot stand up for 5 minutes.
Well, I'm glad the Lord has done it, my dear. And to you be the praise, wonderful Jesus. Wonderful Jesus. Lift your hands and praise Him. Lord, we praise. Lord, we praise. Lord, we praise your holy name. Lord, we praise. Lord, we praise. What happened to the man?
Pastor, he had diabetes for 23 years.
He had what?
Diabetes.
Diabetes.
For over 23 years. Oh. And he had a sharp pain on his back. But
every
as we were praying, he got healed by the power of God.
Is the pain gone, brother? Check it out. No more. What happened to the lady?
She had cervical
scoliosis. Glory, glory. Take your seats. Take your seats, everyone. To the left.
She had cervical spondylosis for 4 years. Glory. She had that collar on her neck. She just took it off now. Cervical spondylosis. For 4 years, she could not turn her neck.
For 4 years, she
just
had,
took off. Power of God came upon her and she took off the collar.
You had trouble with your neck?
Yes, sir.
What caused it?
The doctor says cervical spondylosis.
Pardon?
Cervical spondylosis.
You're worthy to be praised. The Lamb. Touch. Never again will she suffer. In the mighty name of Jesus. She's feeling tremendous power on her right now. Pick up the key quickly. Come on, Greg. Glory. Glory to the Lamb. It's glorious on her. Lady, what are you feeling on you? Huh? What are you feeling on you? Describe it. Describe it. It's fire. Come out of him. In the mighty name of Jesus, be gone out of him. What happened there?
For over 9 years, she's had a sinuses. Her nostrils have been blocked. But tonight, as you were praying, she felt a chill and then her nostrils opened up. She's healed by the power of God. Praise the Lord.
For you are glorious. Touch. 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 What you feel on you? Like what? They need it. Glory, God. Oh, amen. Glory. I'm feeling it now. Help him up so he can talk to me. Guys, it's glorious here. What I'm feeling on me, it's all over here. It's all over. It's all over. It's all over. What happened to the lady? What happened?
Pastor, she fell 2 years ago.
She fell what?
She fell down while playing football and injured her left leg. She could not walk well and she constantly was in pains. Now she can kneel with it. Power of God came upon her. All the pains are gone.
What do you feel on you? Huh?
Heaviness.
Glory. Like a, don't touch her, guys. Ah! Lift your hand and say, I want some of it.
Pastor, for 15 years he had.
Pardon?
For 15 years he had osteonecrosis. For 15 years.
He had what?
Osteonecrosis.
Okay.
A degeneration of the hip, the left. He's not been able
your,
to use his
your
left
hip was getting.
Yes.
Explain that to me.
It's a situation where the blood supply to the hip bone is cut off and the hip bone starts to die.
The hip starts to die, it shall live again. You are glorious. Touch. You're worthy. Touch. You're the Lamb. Well, check it out. Check it out. It's marvelous. Pick up that lady. Was this man healed?
Yes, sir. Pastor, he's 70 years old, and yet last year he had a stroke and he couldn't walk. He came with a wheelchair, but he said his healing started last night as you prayed. So when he was coming today,
have him walk down here, have him walk down there. Keep talking to me.
Pastor, as he was coming today, he said, I'm going to demonstrate my faith. So he left his wheelchair outside and decided to walk, though it was slow. But when you prayed, he said he felt a healing power all over him and he started walking. And now he can walk. 70 year old.
Let's start walking this way. Come on, brother. Come on, let's walk.
And that's his wife, sir.
Pick up those legs. Pick him up. Dear Jesus, dear Jesus. Dear Jesus, every bit of it. Who's the lady?
That's the wife.
Pardon?
That is the wife.
His wife.
His wife.
What happened to her?
She just came with him. She came with him. Yes.
You have arthritis. Well, no one comes up and gets nothing. No one gets nothing. Dear God, help him! Help him back! Help him back!
Pastor, sir, she was at the meeting yesterday.
She was what?
She was at this meeting yesterday. She got healed yesterday. She was diagnosed with HIV. When she felt the power of God yesterday, she went back to the lab. Now she had got...
Whom the Son sets free is free indeed.
Pastor, She has the results now. Negative. HIV negative. That's the result.
In the name of the one who has called me, HIV will never come back. Never! In the name of Jesus. And the people said, and the people said, and the people said, so yesterday, come here, my dear, come here. Sharon Orenuebo. I can't say your last name. Did I just say it right? Orenuebo. So you came last night. What happened?
Yesterday, I felt the power of God in my body. So when I knew I'd been healed. So I went back. As I was going back to the hotel, I bought Fanta. Normally, if I take soft drinks, I'll stool all through the night, like 3-4 times. The lady, we stayed in the same room together. As at 4 this morning, I woke up. I said, I think I've been healed. I took Fanta yesterday. I didn't go to the toilet. I've eaten all sorts of things that I was unable to eat all through this period. And look at me since today. I've not gone to the toilet. I didn't stool. I didn't feel any way.
And you went to the... You
went to the lab to do a test today. As I was in the lab, when the lady took my sample, I was reading the Healing School magazine for this October edition. The lady that got healed of, I can't remember the name of the sickness. I was speaking to my body. I said, my blood is clean. The anointing in me revitalizes my blood. And when the result came out, she put it in the envelope. I was already out of blood.
Well, here it is, the negative report. You see it, Pastor?
Yeah, negative.
You want to say something?
Nothing.
Go ahead. I want you to.
It's amazing.
HIV 1 and 2 screening. So they did, what does it mean 1 and 2?
They did it in the lab. They didn't explain to me. They just gave me the result.
Yeah, that's it. They did
negative the as at 29/10/2016. Okay. There it is. Lift your hands and cry hallelujah. Lord, now I pray a healing ministry will be imparted to her. And whosoever she lays hands on with HIV will be delivered from HIV in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
The anointing is strong on her right now. I want the church to declare, we decree it. Say, we decree it. In the name of Jesus. From this day forth, when she lays hands on men and women with HIV, they will be delivered. They will be healed. They will be set free. In Jesus' name. Now say amen three times. Amen. 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 You felt that go right through you. Describe.
My hands, my feet, my body, everything is vibrating.
Everything is vibrating? Okay, I'm going to show you something. Turn around. Point at him. Point at him. Point at him. Come here, guys. Come here. You got to see this. Point at him. Point at him. You go point at the devil now and say, in the name of Jesus. Jesus is alive. Come on. Come on, people. Hallelujah.
Jesus is alive. Take the lost in
come on, Shina. Come on.
And the brain has been
sing it for me, Shina. Come on.
Jesus lives forever. He's alive.
Hallelujah. lady, what happened to her?
She had migraine headache at the back for over 3 years, and she had general weakness.
Come here, darling.
But after,
wait, come here. Give me your hand. Point at her. I didn't want you to fall.
Give her a full dose of it. She needs it.
Pick her up. Point at her.
Yeah. Sombra Deli.
Lay hands on her. Command it to go.
There's something here. Here.
What is it?
There's something here. Just a second. There was an evil spirit there that caused her to be walking like that from a young girl.
You felt that in her?
Yes, it was there.
It's gone now.
It's gone. She's free. I just know inside me.
You put the two of us together and every devil will run out and get out of here as cowards.
Look at that. Aha.
Pastor, you got to hear this. This little girl came with mother. When she was born, there was an accident. They pulled his hand wrongly, and she's not been able to use this hand. Watch what she can do with it now. From birth.
She could not what?
She could not use the left hand.
The left hand?
Yes, there was an accident. They pulled it wrongly, the doctors. Now, see what she can do with it.
Let me see, baby.
She couldn't do. She has never done that before.
In her life.
This is her mother. Since she was born, she's not been able to do this.
Tell me, mama.
They pulled in hand, and since then we'll be going for physiotherapy. The highest she can do is like this. But this night, as we are worshiping, she now raised her hand up. Say, Mommy, see, I can raise the hand. I said, raise it again. She said, I can raise it up.
Woo!
Oh.
He's the Alpha, he's the Omega. Dear God, this is glory here. Lift your hands and praise Him a minute. Come on. It's amazing the gift you have, Pastor, to detect the demonic. You saw that demon in her back. Is that what you get living in Africa? Maybe I should move here so I can have the same thing. Wow. One thing for sure, put your hand on mine. One thing for sure, I'm coming back tonight.
Sure.
Yeah. Tina, what?
She's had diabetes and arthritis for over 17 years, and she had a blood vision. She was wearing glasses.
So she had diabetes.
Yes, sir.
And?
Arthritis.
Arthritis. Oh, not diabetes, she says. Pardon?
Blood vision.
Oh, vision.
Blood
vision.
Blood vision. And that's my vision. Has been blood for quite a long time now. For over a year. I couldn't read without my glasses. But since I came to this gathering, this is the position I normally keep my glasses. I've not even brought it out from the bag. It has been in my bag. I read very well now. And the pain I have on my leg, it's no more there. West pain. I couldn't bend freely. I couldn't stand up freely. But now I see myself bending freely, standing up freely, and reading very well.
Can you
praise?
Can you do me a little Nigerian dance? Yeah, I want some Nigerian music. Stop playing that Methodist stuff. Let me have some Nigerian Amen. Music. I gotta have some Nigerian taste here.
Go ahead, sir.
Do you have the victory tonight? Hold your head like this and rub it. Aye! Somebody give the Lord a shout of victory in this place.
Yeah, yeah. He is giving me victory. All the days of my life,
I like that. I like that.
Everything that I have now, you give to me, Baba. Lord, I say, for your love, I'm grateful. Yes, you love me plenty, you came to die for me. Jehovah Rapha, Jehovah Nissi, I am that I am. Ooh. Oh, I search around, there's no one else like you. I am Judah, Judah, man, man, man. Is always to follow me.
Yeah, yeah. He is giving me victory.
Yeah.
God is giving me victory.
Yeah. God
is giving me victory.
Yeah.
He is giving me victory. Hallelujah.
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 Jesus has given you victory. Come, let's dance, let's give him praise now. If Jesus has given you victory, come, let's dance, let's give him praise now. Because of Jesus, every day that shall get out of double, double, heavenly blessing that you might receive. Ah, yeah. God, your grace and mercy is always the follow.
Yeah.
He has given me victory.
Oh, my God has given me victory.
Oh,
he has given me victory.
He has given me victory. Double, double, heavenly blessing that he might receive. God, your grace and mercy is always the following.
Bring him up, guys. Yeah.
Things are happening at the overflows. We have information. People are getting healed. And they are standing up there testifying at the overflows.
Thank God. Bring him here. Nigeria shall never be the same again. Yes, ma'am.
Person, this baby had a cancer of the eye.
cancer of the
eye. He couldn't see with the right eye, but now he can see.
The baby can see
the
now.
The baby, yes.
Your baby was blind.
One eye had a...
He had retinoblastoma, cancer of the eye, his right eye. He couldn't see with it. Now he can see. There was a white thing inside the eye, but now it's gone.
So he can see. Close that eye. Close the eye. I want you to look at this, all right?
Yeah.
Turn here. He was there, covering the eye, and it's gone now.
So that white, you said, is gone.
The white thing called the retinoblastoma.
Jesus, I give you the praise. Watch the mama. Watch the mama.
Pastor.
Yeah.
This lady has been a
psychiatrist. I'm trying to stop, but you won't let me.
She's been a psychiatric case.
She what?
She's been a psychiatric case.
Psychiatric
case, yes.
Okay.
She's had mental illness.
Mental illness.
She came with her sister. For 3 years, sometimes she's not herself. But when you were doing the demonstration, you told them to shout Jesus, something came out of her head. She became normal for the first time in 3 years.
A demon came out of her when we said, in the name of Jesus. Stretch your hands and say it one more time. In the name
of Jesus.
Let me tell you something. There's a mighty anointing in this house. I want you all to stand and ask God to triple it on your life. Stand and ask him to triple it. Come on, Greg, get over here quick. I can continue to pray for the people, but there's just so many getting healed. Lift your hands, pray in the Holy Ghost. Come on. Father, triple it on the people, Lord. Those here and those in their homes, those around the world, those in the overflow buildings. Wow. Help the people back. Help them go back to their seats. The winds are shifting in the building. The winds are shifting in the building. Wow. We declare His Majesty. I'm going to do something. And when I do it, something will be released on you. And the Lord is telling me to do this, so I have to. Keep playing it. While I've been ministering, the anointing has been pouring into my jacket. And I take what the pastor said earlier will happen to you. I want the healing line to clear up real fast. I want the people, balconies and lower floor and the overflows. And I want Pastor Chris to just stand right there behind me and stretch his hands towards me. And I want you to come into agreement with me. And I want you to stretch your hands from right where you are towards me like that, Pastor, and pray for me in the Spirit. And when you do, it's going to be a double anointing that will come on the people. Join hands quick, come on. All of you pray in the Holy Ghost while I do that. Because it's come. Powerful. Wow. All right. We're ready. Saints, look at me. Keep praying in the spirit, but look at me. Open your eyes. Open your eyes. No, nobody moving up front. Nobody moving. Brother, nobody moving. No, no, you got to go to the side. Young man, go over there quick. Are you ready? I'm going to just wave my jacket that way, and that way. And when I do, that anointing is going to hit. You ready? Father, do it in the name of Jesus. It's everywhere. Pastor, take your microphone. Declare it on the people right now. We declare it, both of us. Declare it with me.
You have it in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Yes.
How many of you felt like a hot wind hit you? Wave at me.
They got it. It was everywhere, everywhere, everywhere. If you received it, let me hear your voice say, I did. Never be the same again. Never again. Never again. Never again.
And we declare Nigeria shall be saved.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus. Lagos shall be shaken by the power of the Holy Spirit. Every city in Nigeria, from the south to the north,
yes,
shall experience the glory of God. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Now, all of you, lift your hands to heaven.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you. I'm on my way tomorrow morning to go to preach for Pastor Ayo in Warri. And I want you to declare with me that the anointing that's here will be there.
Amen.
And then I'm going to go from there to Abuja. And let's declare the anointing to go there.
Amen.
So lift your hands and say, we declare,
declare
the anointing of God,
anointing of God
will be in Warri.
Will be in Warri.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Monday.
And Monday.
In Abuja.
In Abuja.
Tuesday.
Tuesday.
Wednesday.
Wednesday.
And Father,
we declare
our lives
and our nation will never
be the same,
be the same
again.
Again.
Now, before I leave, I want to do something quickly because I really feel this is very important by the Spirit. I want all the pastors quickly to come and stand around here. And there's going to be an impartation now on the pastors. The Lord has given me a special assignment a year ago to reach out to pastors. I want you all to stand. Everyone remain standing. Everyone remain standing. We'll be dismissing just in minutes. Join hands with me, Pastor. Yes.
Oh, thank you.
I want to say to everyone that the Lord spoke to me very clearly recently. He said, I'm giving you a new assignment to reach out to pastors to mentor pastors. I believe the Lord saved my life last year for this one purpose, because I've been preaching for 44 years and I've paid my dues around the world, and I wondered why the Lord spared my life. And I have intimately known the greatest of all preachers, many of them personally and very closely. And all of them today, the majority are in heaven. They're not here anymore. The healing evangelists today are rare on earth. Pastor Chris is one of them. And I've told him already what a great future he has, and I'm going to be his friend for life, and that is not something I'm going to ever break. He has my number, I have his number, and he can call me anytime, and he knows that. And there's others around the world that God is using. Danny Kalenda is one of them, and my own son-in-law Michael, and Nathan Morris, and Todd White, and young people that have been touched, many of them in my own meetings. But the greats are leaving. They're getting old. And some of them are on their way to glory because of age. We need new leaders and new healing evangelists. And I believe some of them are standing right in this group that God's going to use to release the healing ministry, not only to Nigeria, but to the world. Look, I can tell you, and I'm honest with you, I believe I will come back to Nigeria, but I truly don't know what my future holds. I don't know how long I'll be here. I'm asking the Lord for 25 years. I pray He'll grant my request. I'm still 64. I could have gone a year ago, but it was not God's plan. But I will say this to you, that I truly believe God is raising a great new generation of young people, of great future evangelists that will carry the power of God, possibly greater than we've seen it. And I believe it will be greater. But I have a request from the Lord, of the Lord, that I will not go until I see everyone healed. And when I see everyone healed, He can take me home then. But the Lord has called these two right there to be great vessels of the kingdom of God. And the other young man that was there under the steps a few nights ago, who was that? I don't know if he's here tonight, but there was a young man there that was standing or sitting on a chair. I don't know if he's here. If he is, he needs to come up here or let me know who we're talking about. But God Almighty is going to use him too. A white gentleman that was sitting on the stairs. Remember that? I can't remember. I don't even know him. The Lord did speak to me about him. But many of you standing right here, God's going to use. And all you have to do is pay the price. You have to pay the price. And what is the price? Time with God. That's really the price. The price is not in anything than just simply that. Time with God, time with Jesus. Because that is the greatest price you can pay. Spend time with Him, more time with Him than you spend with your wife or your family. And I'll tell you something. I know people don't like it when I say it. First, the call. Then, the family. Not the other way around. Sometimes we want to be, I don't know what the term could be, but something correct, whether it's religiously correct, it doesn't matter anymore. He said, if we don't hate father, mother, brother, sister, children, we're not worthy. And he didn't mean to go hate them. He just said that they cannot be first in your life. He is first in our lives. When Elijah came to Elisha and placed his mantle on him, Elisha wanted to go say bye. And Elijah rebuked him. What have I got to do with you? When a man said to Jesus, let me go say bye to my parents, he rejected him. And so when one said, let me go bury my father, let the dead bury the dead, just follow me. What was he saying to us? I come first. That is a must. I've told my children, under the anointing, I am not your father. I've told my wife, under the anointing, I am not your husband. I'm God's servant. Away from the anointing, I'm your husband. And I'm your father, kids. Because I want them to receive. They'll never receive if they see me. Oh, that's my daddy. No, that's not your daddy. That's the man of God. And then they receive. So tonight, I'm going to ask God. Because there's two mantles coming. Two mantles. First mantle, you have to serve someone. Elisha served Elijah. You already, many of you already have the first mantle. There's a second mantle about to fall off the chariot. But you have to persist. And remember what happened in the Word of God. God will take you to four locations before he'll ever give you the anointing for that. First, Gilgal. Secondly, Bethel. Thirdly, Jericho. And fourthly, Jordan. That's what he took him and fired him four times in one day. He was doing a zigzag, to be honest with you, if you look on the map. What is Gilgal? Faith. Because in Joshua chapter 5, when they came to Gilgal, the cloud disappeared and the fire disappeared and the manna disappeared. Now they had to walk by faith, not by sight. For 40 years they saw the cloud and the fire and the manna given. Now God said, now you can't see it anymore. You got to live by faith. What is Bethel? Sacrifice. We have to pay the price. Give up things in our life. You can't serve the Lord and hang on to the old stuff, to relationships that God doesn't want you to have. No way. All or nothing. That's the way Jesus told us. And then you have to come to another place in your Christian experience. What is it? It's Jericho. What is Jericho? Warfare. That's when the devil will come at you from every direction. Stand strong in the Lord and the power of his might. Don't let the devil defeat you. Fight and win. Resist him. And he'll flee like a coward. Jesus experienced his Jericho. Absolutely he did. And then he brought him to Jordan. What is Jordan? Vision. You have to experience faith, sacrifice, warfare, and vision before God can give you anything. And then he said, if you see, if you have that vision, you'll have it. That's why he's here. That's why I'm here. You have to start seeing in the spirit. And then that mantle will fall off the chariot. Lift your hands and tell God you're ready for the price. You'll pay the price. You'll live by faith. You'll sacrifice everything in life to follow him. Everything. Even if it means your family, it doesn't matter. Nobody wants to lose our families. But he is first, not family. Yes, we must honor our parents. Absolutely. We must love our children. Absolutely. Love our grand. Of course, God wants you to honor your father and mother. Of course, love your children. Of course, love your grandbabies. Of course, take care of your family. But he is first, not them. Sacrifice. Then fight the good fight of faith. And never, ever give up. We're not here to give up. We're here to go on. Then he'll bring you and say, after you have passed the test, what do you want? Elijah never said, what do you want? Till Elisha passed the test. I want double what you have. You got to have a vision then, he said, before you get that. And he did, and he received. Say after me, Father, I am ready to receive the anointing for the miraculous. Signs and wonders will follow my life, my ministry. Everywhere I go and preach, signs and wonders will follow me. In Jesus' name, miracles will happen. Demons will flee. I will declare the glory of the Lord. I will declare the name Jesus. 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 Now lift your hands like this. You're going to feel something really heavy come on your hands. You ready? It's going to touch your hands. Get ready. Father, Pastor, and I, in the name of the Lord, we release the signs and wonders anointing from every pastor. Touch, 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 touch.
Uh-uh.